Hey everyone, this is Viren and welcome back to my YouTube channel for another marketing tutorial. Now this is an extremely interesting one. A lot of people have been asking me to do this tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can take all your blog posts. So if you're running a blog like me, this is my blog and there are about 40-50 posts here for different subjects. You can collect all your posts and create dynamic Facebook ads. So you will define one large audience and Facebook will automatically decide which article to show to which user based on which sort of audience starts responding to your ads. This is extremely similar. In fact, this is what a lot of e-commerce sites do as well, where they will create a catalogue of their product, which basically means like an Excel sheet which has a list of all their products. And they will just upload one product feed to Facebook and then they will start advertising. And a lot of times what you might have noticed is if you're searching for a product on Amazon and you immediately start seeing ads for similar products from Amazon on Facebook or Instagram, this is exactly what is happening. So you can even use Facebook Pixel to see who is clicking on these ads and showing them related ads. There are a lot of possibilities, but in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to basically set this up for a blog. That is what I'm running here. So it'll be of great help if you have Facebook Pixel set up. I'm going to go into my ads manager here and go to pixels. Click on Viren's Pixel. This is the pixel ad set up for my site. Now, I'm not going to show you again how to set up the pixel. However, I will link up the video in a card right here. You can click on it and watch that tutorial if you want to set up a pixel. This is not absolutely necessary for this tutorial for you to do, but then I'd recommend doing it. What I'm getting here is a page view whenever someone opens any page on my website. That is all it is. Now, in order to get started with this ad, Facebook dynamic ads, you will first have to create a product feed. Now, Facebook by default does not give an option for bloggers to create something like this. So what we will do is create a product feed, but for our blog, which means that there'll be a lot of fields like availability, price of the product and stuff like that. And we'll just have to work around that. And I'll show you how. So first you need to make a Google sheet. I'm going to show you one that I've already created. This is the one. This is basically a Google sheet. You can go to docs.google.com and create a spreadsheet. These are the columns you need to add. I'm going to share the link to this feed on the description below. You can check it out. Check out this one that I made and probably make a copy. You need to give all your blog links an ID. This is something I've exported right out of WordPress. So you can do that as well if you're running your blog on WordPress, or you can just create one yourself. Now, availability and condition is a field that Facebook requires, but since we are working with blog links and not exactly products, we're just going to write in stock and new for everything. There's a description. There's an image link. The image needs to be big enough for Facebook to use for ads, so do make sure you follow those guidelines. And this is basically a link to my site where the image for this post is there. And this is the link of the post title. Now, price is something, again, Facebook requires you to add to this product feed. But since these are blog posts, I've marked price default as zero. And finally, is something called brand, where I've just mentioned my name. This is the basic setup. All of these fields are required. There are a lot of other fields that you can add if you're actually doing dynamic ads for your products. You can go check it out. I'll leave a link to this on the description as well, where you can see the template that Facebook advises you to use for your product feed. Anyway, once this is done, you're going to go to File and Publish to the Web. So we need to create a link to sheet one, which is where the blog have been listed, and create a CSV. Now there are other content setting changes. There is automatically republish when changes are made. That's perfect. So whenever I add a new row, I make a new post and add to the sheet, it'll automatically get updated on Facebook. So let's just click on publish. Are you sure you want to publish? Okay. And once the publishing is done, you will get this link and you need to copy this link. We'll use this to import all of these blog posts on Facebook. Now, next step is go back to Facebook Ads Manager, and here let's go under Catalogs, which is under Assets. Here you will first have to select a category for your catalog. Now, like I told you, Facebook does not have a catalog for blog posts, but we're trying to create one anyways, so we're going to use e-commerce. That's the template we chose. And click on Next. Who owns this catalog? You can select either a business account or personal account. I've selected a personal account. Give this catalog a name and create. Catalog created. Now we'll add products to it. These are the options we can use to add feeds. You can either add them manually here, or you can use a data feed, which we are going to do. And there's also connect Facebook pixel. So if you had Facebook pixels connected, whenever a pixel got fired for, say, a page on my blog, it'll automatically get added to the data feed. So unless the Facebook pixel is fired for a page, it will never get added to the feed. But we're just going to keep it simple. We're going to use data feeds. Click on next. Do you want to download CSV template? Follow the guide. We don't need this because we've already set up one for ourselves. Do you want to upload once, or you want to set a schedule where the feed is automatically updated? I'm going to set a schedule. You're going to begin by adding the data feed URL. So we'll just copy and paste this link from here. Now, if this is linking to some URL which is password protected and needs a username password, you can add that here, but we really don't need to. Schedule, how frequently should Facebook go to this link and fetch new URLs? So I usually make posts once every week or twice every week. So I'm just going to say every Monday at 10 p.m. Choose a name that will help you find this data feed later. And finally, set a default currency. Again, it does not matter to us, but I'm going to select Indian rupee anyway and start upload. The data feed uploading is done. Now, based on the list size and a lot of other factors, this might take a bit of time, but for me at least, it got done in less than a minute. Let's view the products. This is beautiful. As you can see, all my content has been imported, and we can now go right ahead and start creating ads. So let's go into the Ads Manager. Create a new campaign, and this time we're going to select catalog sales. Select a catalog, click on continue. Now let's create an ad set. So first of all, you need to select if you're trying to create an ad for all products or a specific segment of your product. Right now, I'm going to leave this at all products, but let me just show you how you can filter. So these are all the 47 products, as you can see. And these are all the different categories with which you can filter. But these have to be added to the product XML for you to be able to filter this. As you can see, I had just added one brand, we're in bed. If I had added multiple brands to the CSV, this sheet right here, I could have filtered easily right here. But for now, let me just create one for all products. Now we need to define an audience. So use info from your pixel or app to create retargeting audience, or define a broad audience and let Facebook optimize who sees your product. So if your website has a lot of viewers, you can use that info from your pixel and create retargeting audience for yourself, where you can select which events you want to include in this, and whenever that event is fired by a user, they get added to this retargeting audience. But for me right now, since my website does not have that many users, I'm going to define a broad audience and let Facebook optimize who sees it. There you go, I've selected an audience for myself, select a very broad audience with the reach is about 2200 to 11,000 people every day. And the estimated conversion is 7 to 33. That's pretty low. Anyway, let's go ahead and select placements. So I'm going to edit placements, and I want to show these ads only on Facebook feed, not on marketplace. Instagram feed, sure, not on audience network, and not on Messenger. Now remember, to show these ads on Facebook, the images right here on your XML need to be at least greater than 600 into 600 pixels. So make sure that's set in place. And now select a budget. I'm going to select something very small since I'm just showing you this tutorial. Run my ad set continuously starting today. You can set the optimization for ad delivery ad as a conversion event here. So far on the previous tutorials, you've only seen link clicks and impressions, but now we can actually set this to conversion events. You can select a conversion window. Now, what does conversion window mean? If a user sees the ad on day one and then ends up on your website on day six, then Facebook is going to count that conversion as coming from Facebook. So the conversion window is going to be 7 days. If you change this to 1 day, what this means is that from clicking on the ad to the event actually being triggered, the conversion time has to be less than 1 day. Only then it gets attributed to this ad. You can also change it to 1 day click or view. Here what it means is that from seeing the ad or clicking the ad, when the user ends up firing the conversion event, they're going to get attributed to this ad. So I'm just going to select a 1 day click. The event is view content. There are other events here as well. Now remember, you can only do this if you have Facebook Pixel set up. If you haven't, I had a link posted on this tutorial in one of the cards right here. You can check it out. Now the bid strategy, you can either set a lowest cap or you can set a target cost. How much you're willing to pay per conversion, or the lowest cap, set a cap on how much you're willing to pay per conversion. If you select bid, this means that Facebook will not charge more than 7,000 per conversion. If you click on cost, Facebook is going to try and make the average cost per conversion at 7,000, but this is way too high. I'm going to select my average conversion is 1 rupee. You obviously get charged for impressions here, and you don't get charged for conversions. The delivery type is standard and not accelerated. Let's click on continue. And now we need to create the ad. So you can select the ad format as carousel, single images, or collection. I'm going to stick to carousel. Now let's look at the content for the ad. Content display options. There's something called show individual items or show item categories. Since the feed that we sent in had no categories defined, we're going to stick to show individual items. Next, we write the ad text. Let me just quickly add something here. This is very crappy content, to be honest, but I'm just writing anything for now. Add a card with a fixed image video slideshow at the beginning. I don't need that. Add a card at the end with your profile picture. Sure, we can do that. Now, if you have multiple images for each product on your catalog, on the product feed, then you can select this option where you can show a slideshow whenever available. But we have just one image link with each blog post, so I'm just going to select images. The CMO URL is just my blog link. The CMO display link will be vereinware.com. The headline. Now the great thing here is that you can add from the product feed. So the headline is going to be the product name. There you go. The newsfeed description link is going to be the description from the product feed. The call to action, we'll need to change this to open link. Or you can also change it to no button. What this means is that there is more space for content. So to be honest, I would prefer this because at least the titles are going to be visible, and you can add an app link, but that is something we don't need. This is again for product feeds. URL parameters, of course the Facebook pixel running is very bad. Click on continue, and that's it. The ad is live. This is the ad set, and this is the ad we had created. And remember what we had selected. Facebook is automatically going to decide which users should see which kind of blogs. But a more cleaner way for this would be to actually add categories as well, where I could have added categories for social media or Facebook, LinkedIn, Snapchat, different kinds of tutorials that I have, AdWords tutorials, analytics tutorial, and then I could have created separate ads for each of them. Would have been a much more cleaner way. As I said in the beginning, this is something you can use for actual product ads as well if you're running an e-commerce store. If you want a specific tutorial for that, do let me know in the comment section below. And I'll be happy to create something where you can create a product feed right from Shopify or WordPress and link it up with your Facebook Ads Manager. And that's about it for this tutorial. I hope I was able to teach you something new and add value to you. If I did, please hit the thumbs up button. Comment and let me know, and subscribe to my channel for more marketing content. If you're looking to have a one-on-one session with me, the best way to reach me is through Instagram. The link is right here. Thank you.